Three words to describe my surfing. It's a hard one. Bede as a person is a really nice, how would I put the Bede? Bede is a consistent. Bede Durbidge is consistent. Definitely don't draw Bede in the heat in any type of wave. Three words to describe my surfing. I don't know. Pass. Three words to describe Damien surfing. Progressive. Wait, what would you say, like, when you're pumping? How would you word that? Like, when I think of the Hobgoods, I just think of their, like, feet step way up on the board, like, old Tom Carroll style, and, like, weaving through the barrels. The weaving, Damien Hobgood style. I don't know. I just have to put it in, just, fuck, when I think of the Hobgoods, I just think of, like, the perfect way to ride a barrel, frontside. Those guys can pump through any section, you know, whether it's tiny or 12-foot chokes. They have a style that is meant to work in the barrel. My lifestyle? Sporadic, fast, and loose.
Growing up, I just loved surfing. I didn't really know that I would have a professional career. I always just was like, I just gotta find this job that's gonna allow me to surf when the waves are good. And definitely I thought, you know, some things would go through my mind. I was like, I could be a mechanic, because then you can kind of make your own hours. I could, you know, fix cars, and then when the waves are good, I could just go surf. So that was one of them. But yeah, it was basically gonna be a job that was still gonna allow me to go surfing as much as I could. So the secret to that job was being a professional surfer, which was gonna allow me to surf the most. You know, I always think of, you know, how much I enjoy surfing, and and how much of a blessing it is to surf. And so I almost just got a lot of times go back to when I was a kid, or I'll see kids out in the water and you see them just laughing and just really having a good time. And a lot of times that's the way I try to surf. You are at the course and I will run. Set the change before we're done. And you move to find a way to say the things you want to say. Push that we're still. Yeah, I mean, I remember when I was pretty young and I went to Hawaii for the first time, and I saw really good waves, and I just thought, like, oh, I have to go surf these waves because I might never get a chance to surf them again. And I might never get to see these waves again. So yeah, that was kind of always my mentality when I'd see waves that were bigger or gnarlier, because in Florida you never get those type of waves. So I was always just like, I got to go surf this wave because I might never get to surf it again. And just kind of would just try to take advantage of being there.
Ready?
Yeah.
Go for it.
Started surfing because everyone in my family did it and lived near the beach, lived on an island, and that's what everyone did, went to the beach, and yeah, just got into the surfing lifestyle, and yeah, 28 years old now and still doing it. I'm naturally a really competitive person. I remember when I was about 6 or 7 playing footy when I was younger, and I hadn't started competing in surfing, but when I played footy, like, I'd cry if we lost and get up my teammates, and yeah, I was just pretty bad actually. Yeah, it was a bit over the top, and when I got into surfing, I just, yeah, wanted to win and get angry pretty much. I just, yeah, want to win heats and win contests, and yeah, that's what I'm doing now. Is that's my job, that's my income, and I see we've only got a 10-year kind of career, and I want to make as much money as I can from it, but at the same time have a lot of fun with it. But I'm really competitive, and then when I put that singlet on, I yeah, just get a bit ruthless and just want to, yeah, smash the heat. Being on tour, you have so many ups and downs. You have your moments when you win, and then you have your moments when you aren't winning, and you're wondering, why aren't I winning? Like, what's going on? And then everyone on tour deep down wants to win the world title, and only one person can win it at the end of the year. So yeah, you're just putting everything into it, and come Hawaii, if you haven't won, then it's kind of, I don't know, you've got to regroup and get ready for next year. But you got to have fun with it as well, and if you're not having fun, you can't be there, because it's such a long year, and you're away from your family and stuff. So you got to enjoy it, and you got to put in the hard yards as well if you want to get the results. I absolutely love the ocean. If, yeah, I wasn't a surfer, I'd be doing something in the ocean, and I don't know, every time I jump in, it just feels like it cleanses me, and I couldn't live more than 5 kilometres from the ocean. I don't know, it's just something about it I just love, and yeah, it just makes me feel alive, and yeah, I'm just so blessed to be able to go in it every day and do my job in the ocean. It's that's my office, it's pretty cool, and yeah, just, I don't know, it's just the best place in the world to me.
Ian was growing up, he was very active, hyper, always wanted something to do. I don't remember when I was small, but I remember when I got old enough to start remembering, he was always just basically just trying to find something to get his blood flowing through his body. Then surfing came along, and then he got hooked on that.
Surfing was always, you know, this big, big world to me. Like, there are so many places to be seen and surfed, and you know, I looked up to so many pro surfers that it didn't really seem too approachable when I was a little kid, but I still remember in like seventh grade, you know, drawing down the sponsors I wished I had, or drawing waves that I wish I could go surf. And then towards the end of high school, that all started to come into play to have a chance to be able to travel to these places.
When Ian was growing up, he was always like the good kid in school, like straight A's, like never goes out on parties, but just always do his work.
Be remembered however it comes, you know, that's the natural way that it'll happen. And if I, you know, if I had one thing that I want to, I don't know, I guess just for me, it's leaving, you know, a platform for kids to push our sport, make it better, you know, push the sport farther than where I could have even visualized where it will go in big surf and small surf, and you know, give kids the platform to do it. Vegas with us? What do you, I don't know. I mean, he's married with a kid, so he's kind of out of the pool game in Vegas.